Hi everybody! So first off, I have to say thank you. Thanks to my patrons. You know, I am blown away sometimes by the generosity of my patrons. Thank you so much, you guys. You know, the little things help. And if you want to be a patron of the arts and help me bring more of these videos just for you, you gotta go and to my description box where there's a link to my PayPal. Small donations help. Literally, the $5, $10, $20 donations, even those really, really help my channel. So, and the big donations are awesome too. So I wanna tell you guys, my auction is in like a week and a half or so. Totally excited because I have a couple of things that I haven't even shown you guys yet that's going to be in the auction. December 1st, 4 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. If you're not sure how to join the auction, it's really easy. You just come to my channel on YouTube. At that time, there'll be a video, but it's going to be live streaming, and there'll be a little chat box, and you just basically place your bid as you see the art that you are wanting to bid on, and then the highest bidder wins and you're responsible for shipping, and that's really as easy as it is. So one other thing, in my auction I'm going to be offering a couple pieces that I'm developing a new technique on, and for those of you who follow me on Facebook, you may have already seen a sneak peek of this technique. But for those of you who haven't followed me on Facebook, I want to show you really quick this gorgeous piece. And there's going to be some pieces like this in my auction. They're not in my preview video, so this will be the first chance you'll be seeing it on YouTube. Let me show you right now. So look at these. They're kind of, I call them pillow cells because they're really puffy looking. And look at, it's the ones at the top, aren't they pretty? And I was able to recreate them one time again. So that's like, there's a couple of paintings I'm gonna offer in my auction with that beautiful effect. And then I'll show you on my channel how to do it once I perfect that recipe and I can get it going every single time. So I'm really excited. Now, to this painting, you guys, this was me trying to work out using very thin paints because I usually use fairly moderately thick paints for pouring, and this time I just decided I'm gonna try to show what it's like to use very thin paints. They don't look thin in this tilting process, but it's just because I'm going so slow. Honestly, these paints are extremely watery. So what I mean by thin is when I stir the paint and lift up the stick, the stream that falls off of the stick goes directly down into the paint. It literally sinks down into the cup. So it's very, very, very watery. Now, one of the reasons I wanted to show this to you guys is that I see these paintings over and over where people are complaining that they don't get really defined lines. And I swear, I just think the paint is too thin. All of this paint is all mixed with Floetrol, so and water. And you can really adjust the thickness or the thinness, you know, based on how much water you put in. And thin paint is great for swiping. So that was my first thought, is I'm gonna try to save this by swiping and getting some cells from that. But honestly, I think because the black paint was the same thinness as the other paint, it didn't really provide a lot of you know, little cells. A few developed, but not very many. But so you guys, if you're having trouble with some of the lines and the patterns, lines being, you know, kind of up and down jagged looking, or some of the patterns being very jagged, try making your paint just a tiny bit thicker and seeing if that helps you, because you can see it does make a difference. In the outcome, I'm just looking at this thinking, man, that was an ugly painting. And I, you know, I can often save a painting, but this one, that one was a no-go. Now, look, I want to show you something really, really important right here. In the center, in fact, maybe I actually need to stop and show you that part again. Hold on 1 second. All right, so there's the second cup I put on. Now I want you to look at the center of this. When I start tilting, see how the center stays put while the paint around it kind of seems to move? See the center? You know why? Because I used some satin enamel white and I didn't, it's just my normal mix of satin enamel. So that satin enamel white was thicker than all the paints around it. And consequently, they didn't all move in the same way. They couldn't cohesively move. So I ended up getting some weird patterns there. Honestly, that's another problem I see with people struggling with is all the consistencies of your paint need to be almost the same. Now, if you're going for certain effects, you can make some of them thicker. Like, I usually make my metallics a tiny bit thicker, and then they will drop down to the bottom of the cup and or on the canvas, and that's what creates some of those pretty cells, especially with the gold. So, you know, learning the consistencies of your paint and what it does, and this could just be consistencies in terms of just adding water or not, will help you understand how to manipulate your paints to do some of the patterns that you want them to do. Now the paint on this canvas is so thin. I mean, it's so thin that I have to be careful when I do my balloon rolls because they'll just go all the way down to the canvas. I do love the pretty yellow that's popping through there. I just thought that was, look at how pretty, very feather-like. And I'm just seeing a lot of feathers. I've never worked on a hexagon canvas before, so this is my very, very first time. And I decide I'm just gonna add a little bit of black in there for some interest and some contrast. So I put a little bit of black, just drizzle a little bit of black on my balloon, and I added it in. Now it is kind of busy, but you'll see I'm only doing it on one side of this canvas, and leaving all the beautiful gold and fall colors on the other side. So now I'm going to add some white back in. So now I have the contrast of the black and the white and all those beautiful colors coming through from the pour that was on that side, that cup that was on that side. And then it's all contrasted with the fall colors and the gold cells. Now this piece, it dried really pretty, and it's so shiny, and I think you could, it's really up to you how you would want to hang this canvas, but here it is dried. Now that's dried with no varnish or anything on it. I just wanted to show, look at the movement, and it's very pretty. I love the contrast of the gold and the black providing that shadow and the orange popping through there. It's very pretty. Now I varnished it with the ultra high gloss varnish technique that I have, and look how shiny. It's really hard to tell, but it's truly stunning. Just has a glass-like quality to it. All of the metallics are just popping out of it. So I am excited. This one will be available at my auction. So I hope to see you guys there, and I look forward to it. Thank you so much. Like, comment, subscribe, and do not forget to hit the notification bell so I can keep making more of these art videos just for you.